your NCERT book with you. Yes, it is there. Yeah, raise hands. Yes. Yeah, okay. So yes, it's 7:15. So we can start the class now. Photosynthesis. So I'll just have a check. Can you see this clearly? Can you see this photosynthesis term clearly? Yes or no? Yeah, David says yes. All right. Okay. Cool. So photosynthesis, this comes in what? Plant physiology, right? So you have already learned few chapters in the plant physiology unit. What are those chapters? Transport in plants, right? Then you have learned after this, what chapter you have? Correct me if I'm wrong, okay? Mineral nutrition. And then the next chapter is what? Transport mineral. The next chapter is your photosynthesis. After this, you have respiration in plants. And then the last chapter of plant physiology chapter is plant growth and development. Right? So from plant physiology, we will be covering up photosynthesis and respiration. So we are going to discuss photosynthesis and respiration. Okay, so today we'll start with photosynthesis topic. Cool? Yes. Yeah. Okay. So photosynthesis, I'm writing it again. It just has two words in it, right? Photo plus synthesis. Photo. What is the meaning of photo? Answer it in the chat box quickly. What is the meaning of photo? Yeah? Yes, you're right. The meaning of photo is light. And synthesis? Putting together. Right. So what are you going to do? Actually, this photo term is a Greek word. Okay. It has come from a Greek word called as phos. So this phos, the meaning of phos is light. Okay. So this phos, Greek word, which means light, and synthesis, you put together. So how are you going to put together light? How are you going to put together light and do some synthesis? Right? So how are you going to do that? So obviously you don't do it, right? You can't do it. Why you cannot do it? Because are you autotrophs? Yes or no? Answer it in the chat box. Abhishek says we are not autotrophs. Then what are we? Are we dependent on any organisms? So if any organism is dependent on others for food or nutrition, you call them as, yes, Shreya, you are right. It is heterotroph. So we are heterotrophs, whereas plants are autotrophs. So plants are the one which are going to do some magic. They are going to put together light and give you what? Food. You are going to be dependent on the food which is synthesized by the plants, right? So plants are going to put together the light in some way possible to give us food, right? So in detail, if you see, it's not that simple to understand like how plants started to give us food. Before, we were not knowing that how plants are helping us in surviving. So there were so many scientists who had come, who gave contributions to help us in understanding the concept of photosynthesis, right? So who is the father of zoology? Tell me fast, quickly in the chat box. father of zoology or father of biology? Aristotle, yes, Preksha, Sanju, you all are right. Perfect. Okay. So, father of zoology or father of biology? So, this scientist gave some contribution towards photosynthesis. What he said and the theory which he gave was humus theory. Okay. So humus, what is humus? The organic content which gets mixed in the soil that gives you humus. One day we all are going to die, right? Living organisms die at one point of time. So when they die, they are going to be get mixed up with the soil, right? And from the organic matter, like we all are made up of what? Chemicals? Organic matter? John? Right? John? Big four, you say? So all these are going to get mixed up one day into the soil. And there is a process behind it to get the humus. Okay, so Aristotle gave humus theory. So humus is present in the soil. He says that the humus which is present in the soil having the organic matter. This humus, soil is there. And on the soil, obviously, you get a plant, a tree. So this plant, humus is present in the soil. Get what? This plant gets the humus from the soil. And what is present in the humus? You can have organic as well as inorganic matter. So these organic and inorganic matter from the soil plant is using. And this theory was given by Aristotle. So the theory was humus theory given by Aristotle, who says that you have what? Organic, inorganic matter present in soil and plants get organic and inorganic matter from the soil. Is that right? Yes, understood? So that's the first theory that how plants give us food. Okay. Next is second one. Okay. Stephen Hales. He is called as father of dash. Someone knows? Is there anyone who knows the answer for it? Stephen Hales is the father of what? Stephen Hales is the father of? Yes? Okay, I'll help you out here. Plant. And then the first letter is P, ends with the letter Y. Fill these blanks. Father of plant dash starts with the letter P, ends with the letter Y. Yes, yes, Vijayalakshmi, you have got it right. Yeah, plant physiology. Stephen Hales is called as the father of plant physiology. Okay, so what explanation he had given? That air and light are important for nourishment of the plant. Okay, so for the nourishment of the plant, the nutrients which plants are taking in, that is with the help of air and light. That was the contribution by Stephen Hales that he had observed. Cool. So after Aristotle, we learned about Stephen Hales, called as the father of plant physiology. And he says that air and light is important for the nourishment of the plant. Cool. Now, these two are not given in NCERT. Now, the next one which we are going to see is already given in NCERT. What I am writing? Can someone tell? Ending with the letter Y. Joseph Priestley. Yes, Vijayalakshmi, you are right. Joseph Priestley. Okay. So, Joseph Priestley, what he had given us what contribution he had given Joseph Priestley? He has role in the discovery of oxygen. In 1774, he had discovered oxygen. Right? Need of oxygen. Role of air in photosynthesis. Correct. So he had done some experiments. Which experiment? Bell jar experiment. Right? Yeah, mice. Yes, yes. So let's say there is a bell jar here. There is a bell jar here. Closed bell jar, okay? I am taking closed bell jars. Okay. In one, just to understand, we have a candle. In another one, we have a mouse, mice. Okay. So when it is closed, completely closed, fully packed, there is no air coming in. What happens after some time? The glowing candle does not glow anymore. Okay. And the mice which was surviving here dies. So when the chamber, when this chamber was closed, when the flask was closed, when this flask and this flask was closed, the burning candle stopped glowing and the mice who were surviving dies. Okay. So after this, what he did? He tried another bell jar having candle and having a small mint plant. Like tulsi and all, they are mint plant, right? Yes. So this mint plant, when it was there inside, though it was closed, the mint plant and the candle both were surviving. Okay. Okay. Both were surviving. So this gave him the idea that whatever the candle was emitting out, whatever the candle was emitting out, that plant was taking in. And whatever the plant was emitting out, that candle was taking in. Got it? Similar case with mice also. So whatever mice was giving out, plant was taking in. And whatever plant was giving out, mice was taking in. So that way the cycle was running and the plant was also surviving and the mice was also surviving. So mice and candle, whatever they were giving out, whatever they were exiting out, whatever they were emitting out, that was recovered by the plant. Okay. And later on, in 1774, he could discover that it was what? Oxygen, which was emitted out from the plant. Clear? Yes. So that was the bell jar experiment. So they ask you in which year oxygen was discovered. So in the year 1774. And they ask you what? That who did it? Joseph Priestley. Then they ask you that bell jar experiment was done by whom? Joseph Priestley. Okay. These three things you need to keep in mind. Now next is, you have fourth one, right? Three we discussed, only three. Engine housed. Okay. So he had discovered that what is very important for photosynthesis to take place? Light. Okay. So light was very, very important for the photosynthesis process. So for that, obviously he had done some experiment. So the experiment which he did showed that in the presence of light, photosynthesis was happening. When light was not there, photosynthesis was not happening. Okay. And then he also did one experiment with an aquatic plant. Okay. So the aquatic plant, first case, he kept in sunlight. Okay. So this plant is kept in sunlight. Second case, there was no sunlight, which means it was kept in dark. Cool. So plant kept in sunlight. This is an aquatic plant. Okay. So what happened? Water was present everywhere. they started to get bubbles. So from the green part of the plant, what happened? Oxygen had started to come out, and there they started to get bubbles. Okay, so he also proved that O2 is emitted out only in the presence of sunlight. Whereas here in the dark case, he observed that in the aquatic plant, there were no bubbles formed. Means there was no oxygen getting formed. Okay, this oxygen was not getting formed in dark. Okay, so small bubbles, yes, Vijayalakshmi, small bubbles, they release, they are actually oxygen which come out in the form of bubbles. Cool? Yes, he proved the release of oxygen. The oxygen is getting released. Priestley had just said that it is oxygen getting emitted. The proof was given by him, Ingen House. Okay, so how do you remember this? Like, Ingen is there, no? The term Ingen. So basically, Ingen helps us in what? Starting any machine. Here, Ingen House, you need to start the process of photosynthesis. So the universal source of energy is nothing but what? Sun. So that way you can remember that sun light is important for photosynthesis to take place. And this concept was given by Ingen House. All right. So they ask you, okay, what was the contribution? So you need to say that sunlight is required. Sunlight is required for photosynthesis to take place. Clear? All right. Now next, after Ingen House, you have Von Sachs. Fifth one, right? Yeah. Von Sachs. So what he had observed, that plant is storing the food in the form of starch. He observed that plant was synthesizing glucose. Okay, and it was storing the food in the form of starch. Why there is a need for the plants to store the food in the form of starch? Any idea? See, if you know this, glucose is formed by the plant, right? Green part of the plant will help in the synthesis of glucose. Then this is something called as source, right? At source, you have the synthesis. Yes. And then you need to transport this to each and every part of the plant, down also and up also. That transportation happens in the form of, transportation of glucose happens in the form of sucrose. Yes, Sanjay, you're right. Sucrose. I was waiting for the answer. Okay. Now, as we store glucose in the form of glycogen, plants store it in the form of starch. Now, what's the reason behind it? Why glucose is not stored? Why is it stored in the form of starch? Glucose is highly active. Okay, which means it can react. The OH group can react. But starch is inactive. All right. Glucose is active. Second reason is what? It is soluble in water. All right. And starch is insoluble in water. Cool. Okay, so since starch is inactive, it will not get converted into fructose. Only when you have fruits, who had asked Rakshit, only when you have fruits, so you need to make complex carbohydrates here. So when fruits are getting formed, this glucose is converted to fructose there. Fructose is also called as fruit sugar. Got it, Rakshit? Okay, so Von Sachs, the discovery of Von Sachs was that plant synthesizes glucose and that is stored in the form of starch. All right. So that is von Sachs. This is fifth scientist. Sixth one, we can learn about Engelmann. So what he had discovered? Any idea? Engelmann? What he had discovered? Yeah, something related to prism. Physics, you need to apply a bit here. If white light is passed, what happens if white light is passed through a prism? Splitting of light happens, correct. Right? So, white light splits into what? Vivgyor, right? Yes. So these light got splitted when he kept prism. All right. Yeah, seven color. So here he took what? Aerobic bacteria. So aerobic bacteria means what? They require oxygen. Okay, that is why we use the term aerobic. Cool. Yes, so aerobic bacteria like Cladophora. Now, Cladophora is an algae. Okay, green algae. So this algae, green algae, which means it will do photosynthesis. Now light is passed, falling on the plant. This algae is doing photosynthesis. Right? These aerobic bacteria, you have any idea where you will get them? In which region? Blue and red. Yes, Shreya, you're right. The aerobic bacteria were found in the blue region and in the red region. Okay. So in the blue region, aerobic bacteria were there, and in the red region, aerobic bacteria were there. Cool. So, in the blue and red region, aerobic bacteria were found, which means they were getting what there? Oxygen, which means the release of oxygen was happening by absorption of which light? Blue light and red light. Clear? Is it clear? Yes, blue and red. Abhishek is using shortcuts, B and R. Okay. All right, so this blue and red region, at this region, you have photosynthesis, which takes place in the plant. So that was proved by Engelmann. So we say the first absorption spectrum. First absorption spectrum was given by Engelmann, because he proved it, right? That at the blue region and the red region, we were getting bacteria, aerobic bacteria. So at the blue and red, you were getting aerobic bacteria, which means plant was absorbing blue wavelength of light and red wavelength of light. Clear? Yes. So in the blue and red region, he observed more aerobic bacteria. Okay. And rest colors were not used. All right. So after Engelmann, we can move on to the next scientist, seventh one. I use white color. Is red visible? I think black is better than red. Okay. So Blackman. Blackman discovered what? Yeah, microbiologist. He discovered what? Dark reaction. We need to learn this in this chapter. Okay, he discovered dark reaction of photosynthesis. Also, he discovered what? He proposed law of limiting factor. Okay, these two in detail we will be learning. We have in the end, we need to learn this law of limiting factor. And we also need to learn dark reaction. So you just need to know for now that Blackman gave the concept of dark reaction and law of limiting factor. Yes, Bhavesh. All other lights are also absorbed, but the chlorophyll pigment which is there, no, in the chloroplast, that absorb the blue and red light. They are most active at those two lights. Okay. So that is Blackman. Now next scientist we can learn about is Van Neel. So what he had done? Yes. Yeah, Van Neel. We are seeing that O2 is coming by photosynthesis process, right? O2 is getting released from photosynthesis. So this O2, from where is it coming? What is that which is giving this O2? Which molecule is providing us O2? Yes, Ankit, you're right. It's water which gives oxygen. Okay. So the proof was given by Van Neel. So how he proved it? He took some bacteria. Okay. He took photosynthetic bacteria. The bacteria which can do photosynthesis. He took sulfur bacteria. Means they were, you just understand it as they were purple sulfur bacteria. Okay. So they were not using water. Instead of water, their source of hydrogen was H2S. That is why we call them as sulfur bacteria. So this sulfur bacteria, when it combined with carbon dioxide, what it gave, you know? What it gave? What was released? Sulfur was released. When water was used, what was released in the product? Oxygen was released. So based on this, he found out that when H2S was there, even though carbon dioxide was present, oxygen was not getting released. Instead, sulfur was getting released. And when water was used, oxygen was getting released. So that is how he proved that oxygen which you get in the photosynthesis process is not from carbon dioxide. It is actually from water. Okay. All right. So that was the discovery made by Van Neel. Ninth one, Robert Hill. Okay. So what he gave us, the idea of Hill's reaction. Okay, so what this represents? Light reaction of photosynthesis. Okay? Light reaction of photosynthesis. All right. So Hill's reaction, or you can say he gave the light reaction of photosynthesis. So in light reaction, what do you have? Light reaction, what do you have? Cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. We will be learning it in detail. Okay. That is the discovery made by Robert Hill. Next, 20th one. Reuben, Hassid and Kamen. Their discovery was what? They proved. Van Neel, he had just said that the oxygen is coming from water molecule. But, yeah, thank you. It is 10th. Thank you. Yeah, so Reuben, Hassid and Kamen, they proved that oxygen is liberated from water. So here they had used what? Radioisotopic technique. Radioisotopic technique. All right. So for carbon dioxide, you know it, right? You can have 16 and then you can have 18 oxygen, right? So he used, for H2O, he used 18 oxygen, and for oxygen, it was, for carbon dioxide, it was normal 16-1. Okay. So what he found out, the oxygen which was liberated, was, which one? Was 18-1. So this proved that this oxygen was released from water. Okay. So the proof was given by them. The proof was not given. The experimental proof was not given by warning. He had just said by seeing the bacteria that bacteria was not giving oxygen because it was using sulfur, H2S. So that is how he explained that theory. But the experimental proof was given by Reuben Hassett and Campbell. Okay? Yes? Okay, you are asking me what is 18 and what is 16? What is the atomic number of oxygen? Atomic number of oxygen? What is it? 8? So, mass number. We can have same atomic number and have different mass numbers. So, if you have, let's say, 16 and 18, they are the mass number. Okay. So, elements having same atomic number and different mass number, they are called as isotopes. That is why this technique is radioisotopic technique. Yeah. So, we are using 16 mass number oxygen and 18 mass number oxygen. Simple as that. Got it? So that is 16 and 18. Cool. Now next one. Kelvin. 11th one, right? Yeah, 11th one. So Kelvin gave which cycle? C3 cycle. Okay. So this you need to keep in mind. Then 12th one. Hatch and Slack. Gave what? C4 cycle. We will be learning about them, okay? They both are part of dark reaction. Cool? Yeah, C4. Hatch and Slack. So that is few scientists' contribution towards photosynthesis. Now there are two things which we did not discuss, which is mentioned in NCERT. Right, in the very first page you would notice it, that they have this experiment done. This is NCERT. Okay, the two experiments mentioned in NCERT textbook before the bell jar experiment, they have mentioned these two experiments. First one is what? What's the first experiment? Light, related to light. Okay, so they say that any green leaf, if you are covering it, okay, if any part you have covered it, this is the dark part, and all these regions are exposed to light. So what was observed? That only in the light part, what was happening? Starch was getting synthesized. And in the black part, in the dark part, there was no synthesis of starch. Okay. So that proved what? That light is required for photosynthesis. Light is very much required for photosynthesis. Cool. That was one experiment. And second is this. Moll's experiment. We say it is what? Name of scientist is not given, but it was given by Moll's. Okay, so we say Moll's experiment. What he had done was, there was a plant. He took a bell jar. Here he kept a cotton, which was soaked with KOH solution. Okay, so KOH has a property to absorb. Yes, what is it? CO2. Yes, we, you are right. So KOH absorbs the CO2. Now plant, what they did, there was a test conducted, starch iodine test, because we know iodine can turn the color into blue if starch is present, right? So iodine test was conducted. So when this was conducted, this part showed what result? Positive result. Starch was present here. And this part, there was no starch. There was no starch. Okay, so here you got the blue color. Here you did not get the blue color. All right, here you did. Since Taj was not there, you did not get blue color here. And since Taj got formed in the green part of the plant, that gave you positive result. That is how Moll's experiment was verified. Okay, so he said what? That what is required? KOH was absorbing CO2. So he said that for photosynthesis to occur, CO2 plays very, very important role. That was Moll's experiment. Cool. So that is all about all the scientists. Okay. Now we can go in details of photosynthesis. Okay. All right. What are the requirements for photosynthesis? Think. Requirements for photosynthesis? Requirements, sunlight, yes. Okay, I have a plant here. Tell me what all I should give to this plant. Sunlight, okay, I'll use. Okay, sunlight, yellow is fine for sunlight. Sunlight, water is required. Blue color, water is required. So roots will help in what? Giving water, right? We also know mineral nutrients are required for the growth of the plant, right? So water we are giving from here, carbon dioxide, yes. So how carbon dioxide they are going to get from the environment, right? And what are they going to emit out? What are they going to emit out? Oxygen. And when transpiration happens, the water comes out or not? Yes, it comes out. During transpiration, the water comes in the form of vapor to the environment. Cool? So the requirements we were talking about, right? So requirements are what? Sunlight. You need to give carbon dioxide. You need to give water. And where is this process taking place? In the green part of the plant, which means you require something here in the green part of the plant. What is there? Yes, David. What do you require? Chlorophyll. Okay. Which majorly is present in chloroplast. Okay. Now, can someone tell me, generally we say that, yeah, green part of the plant is leaf and there photosynthesis takes place. Is there any other part of the plant where you have photosynthesis taking place? Stem. Not only leaves, mesophylls. So mesophylls, they have chlorophyll. So there you get photosynthesis. Stem. How stem does photosynthesis? Stem. Can you tell me the requirement? Stem can do photosynthesis, but only the green stem can do photosynthesis. So what is majorly required is chlorophyll. If any part of the plant has chlorophyll in them, they can do photosynthesis. That is why in general we say that chlorophyll is required for photosynthesis. In general, we say the green parts of the plant do photosynthesis. Right, we do not give so much of pressure saying that only leaves do the photosynthesis, right? So wherever you get chlorophyll, you may have photosynthesis taking place. Since you have more amount of chlorophyll in the leaves of the plants and they are exposed to the light, they are aligned to the light intensity very properly. That is why more photosynthesis takes place in the leaf. Major part of photosynthesis takes place in the leaf. Yeah, parenchyma cells having chlorophyll, they are called as chlorenchyma, and there also you can have photosynthesis. All right, Meghna is right. Yes. Now, this is the requirement of photosynthesis. Tell me quickly the products of photosynthesis. Products of photosynthesis, what do you get? The plant. What products are you going to get from photosynthesis? Yes, glucose, right? Which they store in the form of starch, right? Next you have what? What else do they give? Water, yes. What else? Oxygen. Now you need to understand this, that plants are what? Autotroph. Okay. So since they are autotroph, they do photosynthesis. Not to give us oxygen or water. It is to get glucose. It is to make food. So since they are autotrophs, they need to make food for themselves. And that is why glucose is synthesized in them using all the requirements which we saw before, right? So water and oxygen which we are getting. Oxygen is something which is very, very important for us to live, right? So this oxygen is nothing but what? Just the metabolic product. Plants intentionally do not synthesize this oxygen. It is just the metabolic product. Okay, it is just the byproduct in the process of photosynthesis. Plants' full focus is to make what? Glucose, to make food for themselves. Cool? Yeah, they are the secondary products. Yes, Ravi, you are right. Okay, so what are the reactants? Reactants for photosynthesis, carbon dioxide, water, green part of the plant, right? And what? Sunlight, light energy. And what are the products? Glucose, water, and oxygen. Right? Now, coming to the balanced equation, do you know the balanced equation of photosynthesis? How many CO2 I should write here? How many CO2? 6. Very good. How many H2O? We say is 12. Okay, then it is 12. Glucose, how many? How many glucose? 1 glucose. C6H12O6. How many water molecules in the product? 6. How many oxygen? 6. Right? So this is the balanced equation of photosynthesis. Sometimes they also ask you question based on the equation. They give you the equation. They will ask you ki how many CO2 is required, how many H2 is required, like that. Cool? Very easy. Now I want you to think here, 12 H2O we are using, right? Out of that 12, 6 is coming here. Yes? Now tell me that why do we require 12 H2O? Anyway, 6 is coming out, right, in the product. So why can't we take only 6 H2O? Why are we taking 12 H2O? 6 is already coming out, right? I want to know the reason. So by the end of this class, I want you to think about this and let me know the answer for it. Why do we take 12 H2O here? Okay? Why 12 H2O? Why not 6 H2O? Transportation. Okay. Keep thinking. 6 will be used. So why do we take 12 then, Ankit? All right. So that's the reactants and products. Cool? Now, so we have this 6CO2. Plus 12 H2O gives you C6H12O6 plus 6O2 plus 6H2O. Tell me quickly, this glucose is coming from which molecule? Water or carbon dioxide? Carbon dioxide, very good. This oxygen is coming from which molecule? This oxygen is from which molecule? Very good. Wonderful. Water. And this water is from where? Obviously, the hydrogen will be from here. Hydrogen is from this. What about oxygen? You see how many oxygen is there here? 6 oxygen. 6 into 1. 6 oxygen is here. Now, how many oxygen in the product you get here? 12 oxygen. 12 oxygen. I say that oxygen is coming from water. This water has how many oxygen? 12 into 1? 12. And here also you have 12 oxygen. It means what? That the entire this thing is coming from water molecule. And if entire oxygen is coming here, then this oxygen cannot come from this oxygen. Can it come from this water? Can this oxygen come from this water molecule? No, right? So what is the possibility? This oxygen is coming from where? This oxygen is coming from where? Do you get any other molecule having oxygen? Carbon dioxide. Yes, Niharika. Perfect. You have got the concept. Okay, this is very much asked question. They ask you, the oxygen of water is of which molecule? This oxygen is of which molecule? And the glucose you get is from which molecule? Cool? So this photosynthesis is which kind of process? You need to give energy. So we say it is endothermic process. There is any other term for endothermic? There is another term for endothermic? Okay. Varad Yadav is asking, what will happen if plants absorb more water? Nothing is going to happen. Anyway, plants have so much of water in them. How much is getting used? That we are seeing there. Only the 12 molecules of water is getting used in photosynthesis. Yes, we have another term, endergonic. Okay. So if I say endothermic, endergonic, it means it is going to use ATP. We will see how, from where this ATP is going to come. That we have to see. From where you are going to get this? Can someone tell me? Which reaction, dark reaction or light reaction? From where are you going to get this ATP? Light or dark? Yes, Vijayalakshmi. Light reaction of photosynthesis. Cool? Now, in photosynthesis process, are you synthesizing glucose? Yes or no? Yes, you are synthesizing glucose. The plants are synthesizing glucose. So it's a synthesis process. Whenever synthesis happens, you use the term anabolic process, right? And then we say it is a reductive process. Why? Carbon dioxide has oxygen here. It is making glucose. What is happening to carbon dioxide? Oxidation or reduction? Just check. Reduction, because hydrogen is getting added to this carbon dioxide. Addition of hydrogen is reduction, right? So since reduction is taking place, we say it is a reductive process. Okay, so you have the letter E, you have the letter A, you have the letter R. You can club them together and you can say, what is it? It's an EAR process here. Right? Yes, Purti. So endergonic, anabolic and reductive process. Now one thing you see here, if I say, if I say that carbon dioxide is reducing into glucose, what is happening to water molecule? Can you check? Oxidation or reduction? What is happening to water molecule? Check. Oxidation. So there is loss of hydrogen. You are getting oxygen here. So loss of hydrogen is oxidation. Correct? Yeah. So why can't I say that it is an oxidative process? Still, I am saying what? It is a reductive process. I am not saying it is an oxidative process. Why? Think. So why I say it is a reductive process? Because plants are autotrophs. The whole main goal of plant is to make glucose. Yes. All of you are answering it very, very correct. Right. That is why. What is happening here? It's reduction taking place. Carbon dioxide getting reduced to give you glucose. Okay, so that is why we say it is a reductive process. All right, so if you want to consider oxygen, you can say that reduction of CO2, oxidation of H2O, both are happening. So you can say it is what process? It is redox process. But when it comes in exam, you need to go for reductive process, because our main focus is on carbon dioxide getting reduced to glucose. Cool? Is it clear till here? Any doubt is there till here? Any doubt till here? All right, perfect. Okay, so we'll go ahead. All right. Ma'am, is ATP synthesized? Yes, ATP is synthesized in light reaction. We will see how it is getting synthesized. Cool. We have to see that also. Yeah, super cool. Amazing. Okay. Now, so we have seen the photosynthetic reaction requirements. The major requirement is what? Photosynthetic pigments. Now slowly we are learning the details, right? Photosynthetic pigments. So which kind of pigments can be called as photosynthetic pigments? Which can be called as photosynthetic pigments? Which kind of pigments can be called as photosynthetic pigments? Yes, you're right that chlorophyll A, B, they all are what? Photosynthetic pigments. Okay, cool. Now the pigments which can be absorbed by the plant. Okay. Any molecule or any substance which is absorbing the light. Absorbing the light. That is called as what? Photosynthetic pigments. So when I say photosynthetic, that pigment should help in what? The process of photosynthesis. Any substance, any molecule which is absorbing the light, that is pigment. Now that pigment, if it is helping in the photosynthesis process, you will call it as photosynthetic pigments, right? So we have several pigments. We have chlorophyll. Yeah, I see some Bhavya writing it. Xanthophyll, yes, xanthophyll. Then you have carotenoids. And you have what? Chlorophyll, xanthophyll, carotenoids. One more is there. Yeah, what is that? Phycobilins. Phycobilins. So one by one, we have to see. The universal pigment, photosynthetic pigment is? Universal photosynthetic pigment is? Yes. Wonderful. Chlorophyll A. Why is it called as universal photosynthetic pigment? Because it is called as universal photosynthetic pigment because any species which is doing photosynthesis, they should have this pigment. That's the main requirement. Okay. So using this only, they are going to do photosynthesis. That is why chlorophyll A is called as the universal pigment. If you remember plant kingdom, you have algae there, right? Green algae, brown algae, red algae. Correct? So everywhere you will see one pigment is common. Which pigment is common? Yeah? Chlorophyll A is common. Correct, Pooja. Chlorophyll A is common. You have chlorophyll A. Green, brown, red algae. And then chlorophyll B, C, D. Right? Like that it is given. So chlorophyll A is common for all species which do photosynthesis. Alright? That is why they are universal pigment. So you also have chlorophyll B. Right? You also have chlorophyll C, D, all these. You also have bacteriochlorophyll. Okay? Present in bacteria. There are two types of bacteriochlorophyll. Bacteriopurpurin. and bacteria wording. Don't panic, okay? I'm going to tell you all of these in details, so don't panic much. We need to learn all different types of chlorophyll, the chemical formula of xanthophyll, carotenoids, phycobilins. Out of these, chlorophyll, xanthophyll and carotenoids, you get them in higher plants. Okay. Phycobilin is the pigment which you get in which algae? Any idea? Phycobilin? Phycobilin you get in which pigments? Which plants? Which algae? Yes, Dhanush, you are right. You get that in red algae, phycobilins. Right? You have phycocyanin and phycoerythrin. Right? So these are the pigments. Okay. So this is a major pigment. Chlorophyll is the major pigment. Xanthophyll, carotenoid, phycobilins, they are called as accessory pigments. They are called as accessory pigments. They help in photosynthesis. All right. So that is just the basic idea about pigments. Cool. Now, today's class, we will, the theory part, we will wrap it up here, the theory part. We'll do some questions. Cool. Based on whatever we have learned till now, we will have some question answer session. All right. If there is any doubt till here, you can ask now. Yeah? There is no doubt? All clear? Yes. Awesome. Okay. So, going back to the question answer session. Yes.
Rahul.
Yeah, we'll do the polling now. Question number one. Is it clear to everyone? Question number one. Shall I zoom it? Question number one. Yeah. So first question. Read this question quick. I'll launch the poll. You want me to zoom it? Okay. Now I think it is fine. Yeah. So let me launch the poll.
Rahul.
Okay, so I see so many answering A. Synthesis of complex organic substances from simple inorganic raw materials in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll is called as photosynthesis and it's an anabolic process. Help me in launching the poll. That option thing. If I launch, I should have some options here in MCQs. I think here I'll get. Yeah. So from question number two onwards, you can answer it in the poll which I have launched. Okay. For question number two, I'll launch it now. Can you see the question? For question number two, which one of the following is the correct reaction for photosynthesis? Okay, I'll give you a few more seconds. Please answer it in the poll, not in the chat box. Pooja, Nikita, please answer it in the poll. Okay, so are you not finding the poll on the screen? Why is everyone answering in the chat box? Please do it on the poll, the launch poll. Okay, I'll end the poll. D, yeah, correct answer is D. Okay, so for the third question, they are saying they are not seeing the polling. What, why? You are not able to see the launched poll on your screen. You can see the poll, right? Please answer it in the poll. Please answer it in the poll for third question. This third question. Moles half leaf experiment proves that what is essential for photosynthesis? No poll. B. Why there is no poll? Let me end it. Share results. I don't know why it's not coming. Okay, we'll do in the chat box itself then. I don't know what is the problem. For question number 4, quickly we'll finish up. Question number 4. Who demonstrated that green plants purify the foul air produced by breathing animals and burning candles? Yeah. Awesome. All of you are getting it right. Yeah, Virat. Yes. Okay. Yes. Anytime, if you have any doubt, you can raise your hand and say that you have some doubts, okay? Question number 5. Come to question number 5. Which of the following scientists concluded that green plant part play a role in purifying the noxious air? Green part of the plant. Help in purifying. Question number 5. In the presence of light, that is very important. In the presence of sunlight, right? B. Yes. Next question, quickly. Next question, 6th one. Engine housed. So what he had done? In bright sunlight, small bubbles were formed. So what was it? Oxygen? Yes, O2. Yeah, correct. Cool. Yes. Now next question. 7th one. Who provided the evidence that glucose is formed during photosynthesis and it is stored in the form of starch? Who provided this evidence? So, you can remember this way. Starch and sacs. Sacs starts with the letter S and starch also starts with the letter S. So you can remember that way. Okay. Question number 8. We'll go to question number 8. Who used the prism and cladophora algae and aerobic bacteria? Engelmann? So now you are getting the idea like how they frame the question. Yes. So this is how they frame the question. Okay. Next question. Question number 9. Who after conducting experiment on purple sulfur bacteria proved that O2 evolved during photosynthesis comes from water and not from CO2? Yes. Everyone is doing it right. Okay. Very easy, right? Yeah, I see all of you answering C. Perfect. Okay. All right. Can we go to the next question? Next question. Only when I say you go to the next question, okay? Don't start answering the next question until I say. Question number 10. Which equation do you feel is right? Question number 10. Yes, yes. Ekdam, perfect. Yes. D. Questions are very easy, I guess, right? Yes. D. Yes, yes. Okay, cool. Okay, next question, quickly. Who answers first? Yes, yes, next question. Meghna answered it first. Cool. Question number 11. Green plants are incubated with this. Which of the following molecule will become radioactive? Yeah? Yes, Vivek. A. Yes, yes. Someone is Neha also here. Yeah. We share the same name. Okay. All right. Come to the next question. Fast. 12th. Who answers it first? Sanket. During high light intensity, the chloroplasts align themselves. A. Okay, I have this question. You can answer this in the chat box. Okay, this question is for what? When there is high light intensity, how the chloroplast is aligning themselves? So the answer you said is what? In the vertical position. Okay. So let's say, you all can see me, right? Let's say this is the mesophyll cell, this surface. Okay. Light is falling from up. Light is falling from a high light incident. The case here is what? The intensity of the light is high. So if high light intensity is coming, what will happen to the chlorophyll? They will get oxidized. That we do not want. So what they do? They become like this, parallel to the light intensity, so that they don't get photooxidized. Now let's say light intensity is less. So chlorophyll will require more light. So what they do? They expose the whole area, the entire area. So slowly what will they do? They'll become perpendicular to the intensity of the light. You can't do anything about the intensity of light, right? Sun is always up, right? So from the sun, light intensities are falling like this. If it is low, what is this? Perpendicular or parallel? Perpendicular, right? So when the light intensity is low, the surface will be perpendicular to the light intensity. When it is very high, it becomes parallel so that it does not get photooxidized. Cool? So this question which they had asked was what? For high light intensity. That is why it was parallel. All right. Okay, no problem if you, like, maybe there was some internet issue there at your place. So I, whatever I said, did you connect that, Nitesh? Like, whenever light is falling from up, if high light intensity is there, chlorophyll will never want to get photooxidized. That is why they are parallel. If low light intensity is there, they will increase the surface area to get more light. That is why they make the surface perpendicular to the light intensity. Cool? Question number 3. Fast. Correct match. Question number 13. Correct match. Who answered it first? Amulya answered it first. Okay. I wish I could hear you all.
Yeah.
Okay. Then question number 13 is done. Anyone, if you have any doubts, you can post it here in the chat box. Okay, so I'm going to the next question. Question number 14. Okay, I think we have not discussed it. All right, so from here onwards, we will be discussing it in the next class. This is based on the pigments, okay, the formula, chemical formula. This question which you are seeing, question number 23, that is based on absorption spectrum and all. Okay, so this also we will be seeing. Okay, so these all questions you need to, I will be posting a pic of it also. As a homework, you can solve it. And we'll be discussing the topic also in the next class. So we will be meeting again, same time on Monday. Okay. Monday evening. So any doubts you have? Any doubts? Did you understand? Yeah. Yeah, Naren is saying on Tuesday. I think Monday there is no class, right? So I'll be posting some assignments on the WhatsApp group. You can complete that assignment as homework. And you can learn C3 cycle is there, no? Just get the gist of it. Like what C3 cycle is it? What C3 cycle is? What C4 cycle is? And what is the difference between cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation? Okay. And yes, I had asked one question, 12 molecules of water molecule. Why do we use 12 molecules of water molecule? Yes, Sanju, you can leave. If you have some work, you can leave. Okay, so the homework is finding out why 12 molecules of water is used. Second is find out the difference between PS2, PS1. Third is find out the difference between non-cyclic and cyclic photophosphorylation. Cool. And fourth is just have the basic idea of C3 cycle, C4 cycle. Fifth is, I'm gonna post an assignment on the WhatsApp group. You can do that homework and we can meet up again on any day. I want to meet you soon. I don't know how soon it is going to be, Monday or Tuesday. You will be posted about it. Okay. All right then. See you. Bye. Take care, okay? Stay at home always. Yes. Bye, bye, bye. Yeah, happy quarantine.